I'm gonna start recording. Alright, bam. Alright, stream's up. ID slash e bubble slash. This guy can say, oh, we're doing caps? Yeah, this guy's smart. Why is there so many caps for friendship? What are they doing? A tough friendship, they're gonna FF the DOS. Then. Why can't a game be organized for once? Is that too much to ask? I just want to get a good picture. If Dime would get back in the game. But why is that guy coming back, bro? Broken time, just line up, bro. What is it? Ben, are you there? It's not even laggy. All right, bro, Ben. All right. Riverside defers. They will get ball at half. Butler is receiving. And we should get to the kickoff in just a second here. Ven, do you mind making the quarter, the first quarter, you know? And not the second. Thank you. It's Intro Mobility here to kick. And here's the opening kickoff. It's squibbed. Flag on the play. Great moves, but it is going to be minus five. Gets him out to the 40. It's going to put him on the 35-yard line. And how I made myself invisible. he just brought us a time. Who is gonna be at quarterback here for this oh, it's gonna be Godspeed at quarterback for Butler. Currently sorting out a too many men problem for Butler. Apologies. All right. Hopefully, we can get into the game soon. Believe we're still waiting for it to be possessioned. And here's the position. Godspeed is doing something to them. And here's the blow. And we're gonna get underway with the first drive of the game. Butler ball. Grizzly ball. And still sorting out TMM problems. And this might be delay a game if he doesn't give the center the football. And there it is. Delay a game. Grizzlies is gonna move him back five. And now it's a timeout. Or nope, I guess they called timeout beforehand. My apologies, I did not see that. Finally, the ball is in the center's hands, I believe. And we can finally get underway. Never mind, they just brought him off the field. They still don't have a ball. And now they do. So, we're finally gonna get this game started. Another flag on the Grizzlies, I assume. Delay a game, minus five. Okay. Pretty sure that was the TO clock. All right, and it's blown. Still waiting for the hike to DS to classified. Takes it up the middle, has space, and it's a gain of about 13. Great first play for the Grizzlies. If only they didn't have all those penalties, it would have been a first down. Here comes second down. Godspeed has it, rolling right. Back to his left. Looking downfield. Doesn't really have anybody open. Throws over the middle. Wide open man. Classified. Has it going down the field. Nobody's in pursuit. I believe that's Kale in front of him. And he's finally brought down for a gain of 41 yards. What a play by Classified. Caught it, evaded two defenders, and took the ball all the way down the field. And now they're in the red zone. Let's see if they can execute. It's first and 10 for the Grizzlies. Godspeed. Rolling back. Throws quick. caught by Mir, and he's brought down for a gain of 5. Second and 5 for the Grizzlies. DSO, that's gonna be a bog glitch there. It's definitely gonna be a bog glitch. You know, bog glitch. Or CG. My fault, CG. And it's gonna still be second and 5 for the Grizzlies. Godspeed. Rolling back to his left. Looking around. Trying to find somebody. Throws and it misses him wide open wide receiver in the back of the end zone. Unfortunate play. Could have had a touchdown. Instead, it's just third down. Third and 5 for the Grizzlies. Godspeed and shotgun. Rolling to his right. Why am I not in biz? Stepping up, looking, throws back, and that's gonna be a touchdown for the Grizzlies. Shifty Mir on the reception. Believe that was at least. Yeah, that was Shifty Mir. And the Grizzlies start off the game strong with a first drive touchdown and great efficiency with the football. And they're just going to be short. And it's a flag anyway. It's auto no good for the Grizzlies. And it will be Riverside receiving the kick, with the Grizzlies kicking the ball off. Disappointing defense from Riverside. Looking to see something better from their next drive. And now, again, having TMM troubles. The Grizzlies would be doing pretty good if it wasn't for the obnoxious amount of players they have and their inability to get off the field. But still, it's blown. Mir is walking around with the football instead of going to kicker and kicking the ball. And here he goes. 7, 5 seconds till the delay of game. And here's the kick. Line drive down the middle. Lands on the 9-yard line. They're struggling to pick it up. Kale with the football. Running to his right. Getting behind his blockers. Untucked. Almost a scary play there from Kale. And we are gonna see Mr. Dime at quarterback for Riverside. And here is a timeout from the Grizzlies. Again, struggling to get their team set up, and that'll be two of their timeouts before the second quarter has even started. If they keep having to use their timeouts to get players on the field instead of having an organized team, it's not going to be very good because they're not going to have anyone on. Yo, HSA just got blacklisted. And they are still not on the field. And here is the hike from Riverside. Dime rolling to his left. Moving back to the middle. Has a man burning deep mid. Is he gonna throw it? No, he throws short. Completed. Caught by Khan. Here's the blow. Offsides on Grizzly on the Butler Grizzlies. That's gonna move Riverside up 5 yards. I mean, bad play by the D-line. Costs your team. So, that's something you never really want to do. And here's the re-blow. Snap to Mr. Dime, rolling to his right. Pretty clean pocket. There's a flag on the play. Free play for the Grizzlies. Looking around for a throw. Has it mid and it's intercepted. And it's actually incomplete. But it was a penalty on the defense, so too many men on the Grizzlies, and that's gonna be a first down for Riverside. And here is Riverside again. Not quite sure what their O-line's doing. Direct snap to Goat, and he gets a gain of about 5. 5. Looked like he would have gotten less there. Bounce yards saved him from getting stuffed. And here's Riverside on 2nd and 5. Riverside has 11 on. And here's a timeout from Riverside, I believe. Yep, timeout from Riverside. And here's the ball. Now I'm rolling to his right. Wide open VX flat. Makes a man miss. And he's tackled for a gain of 10. Great play there. I mean, he was wide open. Grizzlies had no short, and if they did, he was playing the wrong zone. Rolling to his left, free play for Rivers, or for, yeah, for Riverside. Looking down the field, throws up a toss to Kale, and he's popped for an incomplete pass. We're waiting to see what the call is, or what the cause for the free play was. Too many men on Butler. That seems to be a reoccurring problem. And it's first and five for Riverside. Direct snap to Goat, and he's stuffed for a gain of three. There's another flag on the play, and I think it's another too many men call on the Grizzlies. I honestly don't understand how this can keep happening over and over again. At some point, you have to kick some of your players if they keep jumping on when they're not supposed to. But now it's going to be another first down for Riverside. Empty formation. Rolling to his right, back to his left, pocket collapse. Throws quick, caught by VX, makes a man miss, still going, and he's in the end zone for a touchdown. VX puts Riverside on the board, and they're gonna go for one here to take the lead. I believe Butler is trying to run man. One of their players is saying they're guarding the tight end, so we'll see what that is supposed to mean. And now we await the kick from Riverside. Now it is blown. It's a jump play. I believe both teams jump. And they're gonna fake it. It's a too many men call anyway. Looking around. Trying to find someone. Tosses to his left. And it's caught by Butler. I'm pretty sure offense jump, but that's not going to be called. So they're going to get a redo on the play. That's going to probably be an end warning for Zico. And here's another attempt at the kick. Another jump play, another jump from the Grizzlies. Another free play for Riverside. All the time in the world. Looking around, doesn't really have an open man. Still surveying, steps up, drops back again. Looking around, honestly, best decision is a toss here. That's gonna be DBLOS, but it's already a free play, and he's gonna get sacked. It's just gonna be plus five. I believe that's an end warrant on Zico and Intro Mobility, because both of them have done it. No, I meant no. Zico only has one, I think, unless you. Was he saying, eh? I didn't really see it. Zico got one, but here's another jump play and Grizzlies jump again. It's going to be another free play for Riverside. No free play. He most definitely jumped, and I can clip that too. But I guess there is no free play on the. There's no free play called. And it's just thrown out of bounds. I guess it's going to be a no good. Average time pass. He most definitely jumped, I'm not even gonna lie. I have it clipped and everything. And the ball is kicked backwards. Venue streamer Frosty. Alright. And Riverside is going to be kicking. All tied up at 6. And the first quarter is about to end. Probably get a few. And he dives for the kick for some reason. And they're down at the 13-yard line. Horrible idea, horrible play from Riverside return man. And that's going to cause them horrible field position. Godspeed still at QB. First and 10 for the Grizzlies from their own 13. And there's a delay of game penalty. Instead of being first and 10, now they're on their own 8-yard line, and it is first and 15. Riverside doesn't seem to have that many D linemen, so the Grizzlies will probably get away with it, but. If not, then we'll see how this pans out. Godspeed rolling to his right, quick pass, and his wide receiver used his jump before the ball was thrown. Incomplete pass, second and 15. Snap the Godspeed rolling to his left. DBLOS. Free play for the Grizzlies. He tosses to his right and it's intercepted by Kale. It was a free play anyway, so. It's also DBLOS. Oh, wait, no, I didn't. Never mind. It's going to be accepted and that's going to move Grizzlies up 5 and make it second and 10. A lot more manageable for the Grizzlies. It is blown now. Why did he say second and 5? Oh, and it's a DS to Shifty Mir. He gets 5. That'll make it third and 5. Set up third and manageable for the Grizzlies. Most likely we're seeing a pass here. Riverside looked like they were stacking the box and then they backed off. Quick pass, and it's over Certified's head on the line screen. It's gonna set up fourth and five. It's not an auto, they're within 5 yards. There's no auto, it's within five. And Grizzlies are going for it. If not, then Riverside is about to be in great field position, starting in the red zone. Snap to Godspeed, moving to his left, looking for a wide receiver. Doesn't have a target, has Mir over the middle. Quick pass, caught, trucks. And he runs backwards, and he only gains six. It's gonna be hitbox. He had about 9 or 10, and then he decided it was a better idea to run backwards, than keep his forward progress. Ended up losing some yards. Still gets the first, so first and 10 for the Grizzlies. Godspeed looking around, dropping back. Looking for an open man. Has a man to his left. Doesn't throw it. Still looking, and it's swatted down by the Riverside D lineman. Great play by Riverside. Set up second and 10. And with that play, we move into the second quarter. And here's second and 10 from the Grizzlies. Godspeed rolling to his right. He has a man burning down the middle. Instead throws short and he unders it. It's incomplete pass. He had a wide open man deep mid. Ends up not throwing it. And now it's third and 10 for the Grizzlies. Speed on third and 10, and what was that play call? It's a gain of two with Mir line screen to the tight end, and he's stuffed. It's fourth and eight. That's going to be an auto punt. And really, it's not auto. Yes, it is. These guys do. Oh, there's no auto rule. Okay. And now the Grizzlies are going to go for it on fourth and eight. And here's Blow. Godspeed and shotgun. Two RBs next to him. Rolls to his right. Looking for a pass. Has a man short. Throws. And he throws it way too far out of bounds. And it's going to be Riverside ball at the 27-yard line. What was that throw from Godspeed? Had a wide open wide receiver, threw it too far to the sideline, and it ends up being a turnover on downs and gives Riverside the ball in great field position. And here comes Mr. Dime and the Riverside Tigers. Should be a free play offsides call. Instead, there is no call. And is. Oh, wait, no. That was subs. That's my bad. Mr. Dime rolling to his right. Looking for a target. Throws the quick screen and it's incomplete. Running back drops it on the screen. And that will set up second and 10 for Riverside. Mr. Dime rolling to his left, second and 10, has a free lane. There's a flag on the play, and he gets about four. DPI, so it was a free play. And it's accepted, so they get five instead of the four. That'll set up second and five for Riverside. And the Grizzlies are, and Riverside finally has the football back. And Mr. Diamond shotgun. He jumps backwards, nobody jumps. And it's supposed to be a DS, but that's. It's still a live ball, and it's picked up by Riverside. Well, it's. Actually, that's incomplete. I did not realize it was outside hashes. So it's gonna be third and five for Riverside. Chains have not been moved. It's gonna be handoff to Goat, and he gets seven, but it's not blown. It's gonna be minus five for Riverside. And I will be right back. I'll leave the camera right here. If something happens, you will see it in free cam. Apologies, I'm back. Not sure if anything happened, but third and five for Riverside. Mr. Dime rolling back, moving to his right. Doesn't have anybody. Throws over the middle. That's gonna be a jersey warning. That not a jersey warning? Has to Goat, and he gets seven on the first down run. That'll be first and 10 for Riverside. And here's where I cut my audio.
All right.
Mind. It's fumbled. Picked up by Riverside. And he's gonna take that all the way to the end zone. Touchdown, Riverside.